All right, Mr. Sutko here, and welcome back to H1Z1. And I've been checking out the military base. And so if you didn't see the last episode, you should check it out, because I showed the location of the military base and how to get there, or at least from where my location was. And so far, though, very, very uneventful, as I have found virtually nothing in the military base. So far, I found 2 coffee, a hand-drawn map, and a Pleasant Valley area map. Okay, so here we go. This is sort of an eatery. The mess hall. And looks like nothing. Nothing at all. Okay. So, moving on. I didn't check this one. I should go around to the back, because these ones have, like, actual chests in them, and they... Oh, okay. So that one, you can't enter. And I was gonna check that one, because they have chests in them, and it seems like the chests may contain better things than the lockers do. And again, nothing. So I don't see how why the military base is so uneventful. I think they should have at least put some better stuff in here. Although I haven't checked out the whole thing yet, so I'll give it the benefit of the doubt. There's 2 more maps, which is cool, but I don't think every soldier here is a geographer and needs to be making hand-drawn maps, as I think the military has that covered long in advance. I'm ready to find an ArcGIS program in here, which is map-making software, for anybody that doesn't know what ArcGIS is. And nothing. Nothing but maps. Okay, so we are definitely going to move on from this little sector here. And we've searched virtually all of these tents. Although I kind of gave up on some of the lockers, because I was just tired of opening locker after locker and having nothing in it. So we're going to go over here, and there are some dew collectors here. But nothing in them. And again, a couple of people made a base in here, but the joke is on them, as there's basically nothing in the military base. There's a bear over here. Oh, it is angry now. How many arrows does it take? Apparently a lot more than I have. Although I did miss a couple times. I'm just going to kill this bear for fun. There's no reason to really be doing this, but why not? Considering the military base is so boring, I kind of have to. Oop. See, that's the problem with the makeshift bow arrow. Ah, finally got it. Took about 6 arrow hits there, I think. And there doesn't seem to be anything in these towers, as I've checked like 4 or 5 of them now, and so far nothing. Okay, so we are at a workshop. And a friend of mine is saying H1Z1 is glorious. And indeed it is. It is a fun game. However, so far, the military base, not so fun. There's nothing in it. And unfortunately, he just has no idea that I'm recording right now, so he'll probably just be yabbering away and being like, why aren't you answering me? And that is because I'm recording. I should have put myself on, like offline or something, but I always forget. Okay, here it looks like we got like a command tent of some order. But again, absolutely nothing in here. Searching the desks. And this looks like a weapons locker. And there's some body armor here, so I will take that. That's kind of cool. But, the search continues. I didn't quite see if there's actually anything in this tent. It looks that way. Aha, here we go. Here's the good stuff. Somebody was trying to, like, close it off here. Or at least hide it. So, lots of body armor. And it sounds like the rain has stopped. However, the ambience level just jumped up about 100% for some reason. And looks like nothing but body armor. Ugh, boo. Now, body armor is cool and all, but too much of one thing is a bad thing. Okay, so we're all the way down on the other side now. And so we checked over there. Let's check over here. And a debriefing tent. Or a briefing tent, whatever you want to call it. Stupid semantics. Alright, so now we're going to check out this side. And can't get in there. We'll go in this one and then come out the other side. Looks like a bunch of nothing. And we'll check out what's in here. Looks like some grass coming up from the wood. And also a bunch of nothing. So we're gonna go down one more. Check out all of these, just in case there's something laying on the tables. Maybe somebody misplaced their AR-15 and set it on a table. We're gonna check another one of these. I can't really believe that the developers didn't make anything spawn in these. Like, that doesn't really make sense. Seems like they would. Because the checkpoints mostly consist of those towers. And if you're gonna make those checkpoints and have nothing spawn in them, then really what's the... I mean, other than the ambience factor of the checkpoints, because it is, like, you know, a zombie, like, apocalypse kind of deal. Other than the ambience factor, there's no point to them. So it looks like we're almost out of spots to explore here. As it seems like there's only a few more tents left. As that tent there looks like the best spot. Because it has all the weapons lockers in it. And for some reason I can't really get around here. I could jump over this fence, but I'm kind of curious as to where the actual entrance is. For this little sector. Looks like it's over there, and I totally missed it, so... we're gonna jump right over the fence. Okay, so more lockers. They should have a jelly donut in one of these chests as a tribute to Full Metal Jacket. And if you guys don't know that reference, watch that movie. It's really good. Full Metal Jacket. Come on, be a man. Watch it. Although, in all honesty, the first part of the movie is way better than the second part of the movie. The boot camp scene is the most famous part of that movie. The rest of the movie is, it's alright. It's a good movie. Oh, looks like I was missing some chests over here. However, there's just nothing in these chests. A little bit of frustrating experience going to the military bases. There's just, like, nothing there. Except for that one tent with all the weapons lockers. And these typically have nothing in them. So far, I have found absolutely nothing in these chests except for a map. So I really hope they work on adding some stuff in this. I mean, even cloth would be nice, you know, like a uniform or camo, fatigues, you know, anything. Even civilian clothes, just to cut up some cloth. Anything. Yeah, see, just nothing but maps. So I really think, like, the developers kind of, I don't know, maybe they messed up. It is alpha, you know, but maybe they just kind of sort of messed up and didn't really put anything in the base except for the weapons lockers. But the weapons lockers really just, I think they just sort of have their own drop rate or spawn rate anyway. Like, because if you go to the weapons lockers in the police station, you find the laminated body armor just the same. I did check this side. So I do believe that is the entire military base that I've so far checked out. So fairly uneventful. It could have been the case that somebody had just recently taken all of the good stuff, but I'm not so sure about that, as it's kind of a little bit late in my area, and the server, I think, is a medium population right now. So, really, nothing going on, but maybe after this video I might get a hold of my friend, and maybe we could do some H1Z1 together, and kill some zombies together. Maybe I can make a cool video out of that. Who knows? But again, this is where all the weapons lockers are for anybody interested in the military base. This is where the good stuff is. This particular tent. So about in the middle, right there. That's where all the weapons lockers are. And I'm sure you may have better luck than I do in terms of finding good stuff in those weapon lockers. But however, there was only body armor in there for me, which is okay. Also, yes, there is one weapons locker here in the I don't know what you'd want to even call this, the command tent maybe. So other than that, the other spots of the military base, I'm sure it spawns something good once in a while, but for the most part, from my experience so far, the other parts of the military base are pretty much a waste of time, which is very unfortunate. But I even hate to say that, but really there isn't much other way to put it. As I found absolutely nothing except for coffee. So that is it. That is the glorious H1Z1 military base. And I suppose you could find better stuff than me from time to time, but again, that those two tents have the weapons lockers in them. The one has many more than the other. So that's where you're going to want to go first, for sure. You're going to want to go into the main entrance here, and once you go through, you want to go a little bit right, and I think it's over back in that way somewhere. But I think I will call it right here. Although it is a pretty short video, I just really wanted to make a military base video. So I had to get to the military base in the previous video, and I had to explore the rest of the base in this video. Yeah, from this hill here, you can actually see the tent that I'm talking about, and it's right there. You can't barely see it because there's three shacks made by players. But so you can go in the one of the entrances here and sort of go around, and you'll have to go towards the right side of the base. And right there, and the tent next to it, the one where my cursor is pointing right here, has a weapons locker. The ones all over here pretty much have nothing in them. Except for those foot lockers, which apparently only have maps in them, because it seems like all the soldiers here are geographers and are making hand-drawn maps. But I won the video here, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed the military tutorial, I guess, if you want to call it. And I will see you guys next time.